Well, Andrew, they live on our streets, often so secretly, even next-door neighbors are kept in the dark. Tonight, we're taking a close look at a disorder so debilitating, the millions of Americans who suffer from it are literally swallowed alive by their homes. And this is what can happen.
11 people in Manchester barely survived this dramatic fire last March. The raging flames, fueled by mountains of clutter, clogging the windows and doors, keeping fire crews out. Piles of papers and trash, just like these.
Scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the worst. What is this in your mind?
In my mind, it's a 10. It is a 10.
It can take years for a hoarder's home to get this bad. Stacks of clothing, old treasures turned trash, and papers dating back decades.
Yeah. Wow.
But hoarding isn't just about saving things.
It almost seems like this place is eating you alive.
That's a very, very good description.
It's also about being unable to let go.
One of the things my mother always taught me was that you might be able to use this somewhere down the line.
This is an inside look at hoarding, an obsessive-compulsive disorder documented by brain scans, suffered by as many as 25 million Americans.
When I wake up in the morning, that's the first thing I think about is, you know, here it is.
60 years of secrets we can't even get in to see.
How do you explain it?
I actually don't. I avoid it.
A few miles away, this woman is being swallowed by a home she can no longer navigate.
I see too much, and my eyeballs dance because I don't know where to begin.
How does that make you feel?
Crappy. I mean, I have grandkids I would like to have over.
Personal organizer Doria Savisky invites our cameras inside for a look at the daunting cleanup. This is day number one.
It's just grueling work.
It's one thing at a time.
One thing at a time, one paper at a time, one pile at a time.
We find newspapers from 1986, newsletters from 77, 50-year-old magazines.
We sorted everything in three piles.
What were they?
They were clothes, paper, and garbage.
Each bag of trash is almost sneaked out without the homeowner's knowledge, because seeing just one thing removed is enough to send a hoarder over the edge.
They can't make decisions as to what to get rid of and what to keep, because not only for a lot of these people is there an emotional attachment, but they have this obsessive fear that they may need something later, and if they can't find it, it's going to be a huge problem.
1 week later, our cameras return for a follow-up.
You've made major progress.
Yes.
How much trash have you thrown out?
30 garbage bags so far.
Like the big black ones?
Yes. We have found termites underneath, mouse skeletons. Look, pictures, history, family history.
And a note, handwritten in 1944.
Wisdom from the ages, huh?
Love and best wishes, Dad.
By the 87-year-old homeowner's father. It's now week three, and Doria's job is halfway done. The homeowner none the wiser about what she's trashed. Adult psychologist Dr. Alicia Kaplan says hoarders are terribly conflicted.
Part of their brain knows that there's a problem, okay, that their living condition is terrible and they can't live like this. But at the same time, they feel paralyzed and overwhelmed with these items.
And that is where depression can creep in.
You know, you have dreams about the way it can be. I'm capable of more, and that's not what I'm doing.
By week four, Doria's work is done, and the result is astonishing.
Wow! Oh my gosh! You did it! You did it! Wow! This is incredible!
Gone are the piles and the papers and the trash. Left behind is new hope, new space, a new beginning.
They're just forever grateful to have their home back, to have their space back. They get their life back and people that they love back.
Do you think you're going to change?
I am going to change.
Is this the beginning of it?
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
Just incredible. Just talking about hoarding really is a step in the right direction for so many people. That is the safest, easiest start. So if you or maybe someone you know needs help, there are so many resources here in Pittsburgh. Please go to our website, WTAE.com. Click on the As Seen on WTAE section at the top of the homepage to learn more. There you're also going to find a slideshow of photos from inside these local homes. It is incredible, but there is help.